Hey, welcome to Grafana for Beginners. I'm Lisa Jung, and I'm a developer advocate at Grafana. In the last episode, we created a visualization dashboard to observe our e-commerce app. As we observe our system, we're bound to come across some interesting events or failures. By flagging these events and adding context, we can communicate whether further investigation is needed or if action should be taken to address these events. This is known as annotating events. Think of this as adding a little post-it note to an interesting event for your team. It's there to flag an event with just enough context to decide on the next steps. You can add these annotations manually or automatically. You're most likely to manually add annotations for specific events that you don't normally encounter. For regularly occurring events, automatic annotations are used. In this episode, we'll cover how to manually add annotations. I'll add the tutorial to automatic annotations towards the end of the video. So this dashboard observes the same e-commerce app we've been using as an example. It's more comprehensive and advanced than the dashboard we built in the last episode, and it's divided into three sections. The application metrics gives an overview of the traffic that each service is dealing with. The application logs display info about errors observed in these services. The Kubernetes metrics visualize info about the infrastructure that the app is running in. At first glance, these four panels may stand out to you as something that may need to be annotated. Let's zoom in on the application metrics section. You see a spike in service latency, which suggests that these services are taking longer to complete the tasks. You also see a dip in the service throughput, which suggests that the services are handling fewer requests per second. If you look at the Kubernetes metrics, something may be going on with the container memory and container CPU for the product service. Whatever may be going on seems to make this service work harder to fulfill the request. As a result, the service may take longer to complete the task and handle fewer requests per second. Now, these are just initial assumptions, and we have no idea if it's true, but we want to flag these so we can decide what we want to do next. To manually add an annotation, click on wherever you want to add it. Once a pop-up menu appears, click on the Add Annotation option. In the description is where you would add the context and/or call to action here. What you write here depends on the situation you're dealing with. If you want a team member to investigate this further, you would add a note here asking them to do so. Or let's say 2 minutes after deployment, you observe a huge spike in service latency. You would annotate that something went wrong during deployment and ask to roll this back. Or it might be a scenario where somebody accidentally reconfigured the service, which led to this huge spike in service latency. You caught it, rolled it right back, and everything is good. But you still may want to annotate that here so that if another teammate were to come across this, they have the context to what happened. Now, once you're done filling out the description, click on the Save button. You'll see a little arrow added here signifying that an annotation has been added. If you hover your mouse over the arrow, the text of the annotation will appear. Now, you may want to annotate a certain region of your visualization. If you want to do this using a PC, press Control and Hold, then click and drag across a region you want to highlight. Then the box should appear where you can add and save the description. Now, if you're using a Mac, you would press and hold the Command key and follow the exact same steps. At the moment, there's no way to tag somebody within the annotation. So if you want somebody to take a look at what you annotated, you would share the URL of the dashboard using whatever messaging platform you use. All right, we just went over how to manually add annotations to your dashboard. If you want to automatically add annotations, you can do so by writing annotation queries. My teammate Marie created a fantastic tutorial on it, so if you're interested, click on the info card up top to watch the video. Now, as beautiful as these dashboards are, you probably don't want to monitor them 24/7. With Grafana, you can set up alerts for certain events that require attention. In the next episode, we'll learn how to create alerts with Grafana. If you want to access more episodes of Grafana for Beginners series, go to the Grafana community webpage. This is where all the community resources are shared. You can access the series by clicking on the Grafana for Beginners card. Last but not least, as you continue your journey with Grafana, you may need something beyond what's currently available within Grafana. If you'd like resources on creating plugins or whatever else to extend Grafana's capabilities, the developer portal is a great place to start. This is where you can find documentation specific to app development. You can also find plugin tools and guides to help you get started. So make sure to check that out if you need something beyond what's available within Grafana. All right, that's a wrap. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.